That was part of my surprise.
He was like, I apologize for making you carry this.
Yeah, that's why.
Where
was
it?
I
think.
I
don't
know.
Oh my god.
Yes.
You want a napkin? Jeez. Perfect. Wow, that was a great catch.
That was awesome.
Okay,
I'm standing.
Huh?
Is it okay that I'm standing?
Yeah!
Okay.
When did he get me?
Oh my word.
Oh my word.
Oh my god. He literally.
I'm like,
is perfect.
Sorry. Go ahead. So sorry.
He got me a wallet. A Coach wallet.
Wow.
Holy cow.
That's what I couldn't tell you.
And he got me the stuff I wanted. I'm gonna smell so good today.
Even though it felt like it was never gonna come, that it's finally here, I get to
to marry the girl of my dreams. Lord God, I pray that you be with us today. And not just today, but forever.
Yeah.
For the rest of our lives together, help us to be strong and be the husband and the wife that you call us to be,
yes.
Lord God. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Okay. Bye.
Don't cry.
Yeah, right? Love you.
Love you. Holy presence in this place and throughout this day. In Jesus' name.
Amen. You may be seated. Your family and friends and guests are here to celebrate the union of Ashley and Joshua. Who gives this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
Marriage is an institution that has been given the stamp of approval by God throughout His Word. It was ordained by Him in the Garden of Eden during the time when the world was innocent and pure, before the entrance of sin. At the very beginning of the Bible, in the book of Genesis, we find the Lord surveying His creation, searching for that perfect mate for man. But in all that God had created, such a mate was not to be found. And so God, in His infinite wisdom, realizing that it was not good for man to be alone, created the first woman, the perfect mate. And He brought them together and in essence performed the first wedding ceremony with these words: "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." The beauty and the blessings of the Garden of Eden have long since passed, but the institution of marriage has lived on. Throughout the Old Testament, we read of great husband and wife teams. It was King Solomon who said, "He who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord." He also asked this question: "A good wife, who can find? She is far more precious than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value." And as we move into the New Testament, Jesus honored this sacred institution often. He performed His very first miracle in a wedding ceremony in Cana. He often used the marriage and the marriage relationship to convey the message of His gospel, the good news. Then after His death and His resurrection, and after He established His church, we often find that church described as the bride of Christ, which He gave His life for. As you can see, the evidence of God's word on the subject of marriage is clear. It is a union that is not to be entered into thoughtlessly or lightly. It is precious in the sight of God. And because of this, I charge both of you to remember that love and loyalty are the ingredients for a happy home. Combine these with a relationship with Jesus Christ, first and foremost in your life, and you will have a home full of joy and peace. Y'all face each other, please. Josh, husbands are to love their wives as Christ loved the church, and He gave His life for the church. So do you promise to give your life daily to Ashley by loving and caring for her in sickness and in health? Whether you are rich or poor, whether in good times or bad. Say that again.
I do.
I don't think the people in the back heard you. Say it one more time.
I do.
Very good. And Ashley, do you promise to love Josh and be faithful to him in sickness or health, riches or poverty, good times or bad? Then as Paul the Apostle of Christ says, "You as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievance you may have against one another, and forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." Can I have the rings? The ring is a symbol and a sign of the promises that you two are making together today. I pray that your love, like these rings, will be without end. So Josh, please take Ashley's left hand in yours and repeat after me. Ashley, with this ring, remembering the promises I have made today, I now and forevermore become your husband. Ashley, please take Josh's left hand in yours and repeat after me. Joshua, with this ring, remembering the promises I have made today, I now and forevermore become your wife. Josh and Ashley, today in front of these friends and family, you start your life together anew as a married couple. As with any new endeavor, it's best to start with a clean slate, putting problems big and small behind you. You come acknowledging that the person you have chosen is not perfect, yet fits with you in a way that no other person can. Whatever difficulties you have experienced, today you have decided that your love is bigger than any of them, and you have chosen a life together. Water brings forgiveness, and we all need forgiveness. We need to forgive others, and we need to forgive ourselves. Today, as you wash your hands in this bowl of water, forgive yourself and each other for anything in the past. Allow yourself to be forgiven for your human imperfections. And allowing yourselves to have your hands dried by each other signifies your vulnerability. And we have to be vulnerable. It breaks through isolation, and in our vulnerability, we become more caring and understanding of our mate. In a loving and compassionate marriage, to achieve the greatest intimacy, you must have the courage to be open and vulnerable with each other. So Josh and Ashley, do you begin your lives together today with grace and compassion?
Covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.
For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. This covenant with Jesus, Ashley and Josh, is one of love, grace, and mercy. This is the covenant that you two are making today with each other. Love, grace, and mercy with each other and ultimately with Jesus Christ. Father, we just thank you for the great things that are ahead for Josh and for Ashley. Father, I bless these two families that they are becoming one today. Bless all the in-laws and Father, just the friends and the family as they become one. Lord, we give this day to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Josh and Ashley, because of the promises that you have made today to each other before these witnesses and before God, I now pronounce you husband and wife. The foundation of your marriage must be deeper than your love for each other alone. It must be your love for the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus loves you, so you should respond by loving him, which should cause you to want to please him. And his desire is for you to love each other. Remember that what you have done to the least of these belong to Jesus, you have done to him. The love I am talking about is the opposite of selfishness. It is not governed by a feeling, but by a decision. Only by God's help can we walk in it, so we must daily look to him for grace. Josh, guard your bride well, who has been placed and committed herself into your keeping. If you treat her as God has intended, she will give you joy and happiness greater than you can ever imagine. And Ashley, God has created you with the ability to be a great blessing to your husband. Always look to God for help and guidance that you may be the blessing to Josh that God intended. Honor and respect him as the earthly head of your home. May your love be patient, kind, not jealous or boastful, not arrogant or rude. May your love not insist on its own way, not be irritable or resentful, not rejoicing in the wrong, but in the right. May your love bear all things, believe all things, hope all things, endure all things. May your love never end. Josh, may kiss your wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very, very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Joshua James Hafner.
A little one, you don't need it. do? Do you want to get out? What you gonna do? You want to get out? What you gonna do? You want to get out? Tell me. By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
'Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it,
come on and
get down on it.
If you really want it,
get down on it.
You gotta feel it. Standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really won't take a chance? By standing on the wall,
get your back up off the wall.
'Cause I heard all the people saying,
get down on it, get down on it, get down on it, get down on it.
When you're dancing, get down. What you gonna do?
Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get your back up off the wall. Dance, come on. Get down on it.
Come on then.
Get down on it.
If you really want it.
Get down on it.
You gotta feel it.
I'm gonna get me in trouble. Let's sing.
Happy honeymoon!